Hello everyone and welcome to another video on Tutorials Point with me, Richa. Today under the Hospitality Management module, we will talk about types of hotel. Well, if you are somebody who have been around the globe and stayed at different kinds of hotels and types of hotels, you will find this particular module very, very interesting. So let us see what are the different types of hotels. Well, on the agenda, we will talk about different types of hotels. Depending on the number of rooms which are there, they are typecast into certain categories. According to plan for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Eligibility for a star classification. Classification on the basis of the location of the hotel. Classification on the basis of ownership of the hotel. On the basis of level of services, and we will also talk about what are the alternative accommodation which are not really hotels but different types of subcategory of hotels. So, well, what exactly is a hotel all about? A hotel is an establishment that provides paid lodging on a short-term basis. Some hotels offer meals as part of their room and onboard arrangements. So, well, a hotel is anywhere where you have to go and pay money and get a room to stay in. And you also get to use a lot of other facilities of a hotel, like their pool facilities, their swimming pool, their gym facilities, the banquet area, and a lot of indoor and outdoor games which a hotel might have. So, it is something which you pay for and you get services in exchange for the money that you've paid in. Now let's look at different types of hotels. Here they are. Classification of hotels is based on the location where they are. It's also based on ownership and affiliation. It's also based on a particular target market. There are certain hotels which allow only a particular kind and community of people to check in. They're also based on star rating, what kind of a rating that your hotel has. It is based on a particular theme. So sometimes a hotel might have a theme which is for kids only, or it can be a different kind of a theme which may be of a different kind, like a historical kind of a theme as well. It's also based on the level of services that might be there, based on the length of stay, as well as based on size. So your hotels can be of different types based on such classifications, and hence it's important to understand no two hotels are the same. They will differ and they are based on different categories. Let's see the number of rooms classification. What really helps us understand is that small range hotels who have lesser number of rooms, probably between 1 to 25 rooms in a hotel, are known as a small kind of a range of hotel. A medium, for example, a medium range hotels are the hotels which have around 26-200 rooms in that hotel. A big or a large hotel consists of 101 to 300 rooms. And a very big or a large hotel or a resort would have consist of rooms which are 300 and above. So these are the different classifications of hotel based on the number of rooms in that hotel. Let's look at according to a particular plan which many hotels have nowadays. They have a particular plan which helps you decide whether you want to stay in that particular hotel or no. So American plan talks about American plan consists of a room charge plus three meals, which is your breakfast, lunch and dinner, all inclusive along with the room charges. That's an American plan. A modified American plan or a MAP consists of a room charge plus two meals, which is one is your breakfast and either a lunch or a dinner included in that particular plan. So that's your modified American plan. Bread and breakfast plan, which is B&B, consists of continental plan called as a CP. Here, this plan consists of a room charge plus breakfast. So that's your, most of the hotels have this kind of a facility, which is bedding as well as lodging. So they give you a room as well as they give you a complimentary breakfast in the morning. So that's a part of bed and breakfast plan. Let's understand what is the eligibility for a star classification. A lot of times you might have seen on the website of a particular hotel or on Just Dial, etc. You have seen these stars given to the hotel. Now, what is the classification or understanding of these stars? So star classification consists of 5-star or a 5-star deluxe hotel, which has to have certain criteria, like a single room should be at least 180 square feet. A double room should be 200 square feet. Bathroom should have 45 square feet of space. If your hotel has these kind of square feet areas, then you are classified under a 5-star or a deluxe 5-star. A 4-star and a 3-star hotel has to have certain criteria, like single room should be about 120 square feet, double room should be 140 square feet, and bathroom size should be about 36 square feet. A 2-star and a 1-star property should have a single room should be about 100 square feet, double should be 120 square feet, and a bathroom should be about 30 square feet. If your hotel comes under such criteria, then they are classified as a 2 or a 1-star, a 3 or a 4-star, or a 5-star property. Classification on the basis of location. Now let's understand, there are different locations which a hotel has. So classification on the basis of suburban hotel, wherein it's located in the heart of the city, in the suburbs of the city, then it comes under suburban hotel. Resort hotels are generally not located within the city. They are located a little on the outskirts of the city or on a probably a hill station kind of an area. So they give you a feeling and a view of mountains, rivers, oceans and seas, etc. And that's where a resort hotel comes into picture. A business hotel is a typical kind of a hotel wherein you don't have too many facilities. It's just that you are there during the day, not there during the daytime. You are there in your office or workplace during the day, and you just go there for sleeping in the night so that you are refreshed in the morning and then you're back at work. So generally a business hotel would not provide you too many extra luxurious facilities. Airport hotels are generally located in close proximity to the hotel. Again, the basic idea of an airport hotel is for people who have a flight to catch immediately after a meeting or something, and they don't really want to travel too far away from the airport. So these are the hotels which are located really near to the particular airport in that city. Now let's look at classification on the basis of ownership. Well, there are certain hotels which are independent hotels which do not have anybody else running the hotel but their own people running, so it's independent of anybody. There are certain hotels which have a particular chain. For example, a Radisson Blue will have different chains, or a JW Marriott will have, in different cities they'll have a chain of hotels. Management contracts. Now there are certain hotels which are taken over by certain contractual companies. It is basically their estate and their contract under which they get a hotel into their contract. And then you have some hotels like a franchisee. For example, OYO Room or a Fab Hotels again has many franchisees under them. On the basis of the level of services, now services is something that you have to definitely expect when you go and check into a hotel. So there are certain hotels which will give you the level of service like excellent, which is world class and upmarket, and you definitely will be paying a bomb for these kind of services. So be rest assured, when you are checking into a luxury hotel or a world class hotel, you will definitely have the world class service given to you. Mid-market or mid-range service hotels, do not expect very high level of service from them. They are mid-range and they will not offer you a very great attractive services. Your budget and economy hotels like OYO Rooms as well as Fab Hotels and other few in the market nowadays are budget hotels. So their main concern is only by giving you simple services, not very extravagant services. So if that's something that you're looking at, you will be in for disappointment if you check into a budget or an economy hotel, because their idea is not to give too great services. They're very simple and they will just take care of your basics. Well, if you do not want to check into a hotel or do not have that kind of budget to go into a hotel which might be a little expensive, there might be alternative arrangements or accommodations which you can look at. One of them being Dharamshala. Again, a Dharamshala is a kind of a accommodation wherein you will not have any other facilities apart from a room which is given to you, and probably a cafeteria or a dining facility which might be a part of that Dharamshala. You also may check into a bungalow. A lot of people give out rental bungalows wherein you can go in and stay there, and they will have people who will do the housekeeping in that bungalow. Your stay will be very comfortable. You will also get your meals prepared, and there might be an in-house kitchen over there, people who will do your entire laundry work and everything else. Lodges are again similar kind of facilities wherein your boarding and lodging is taken care of, and there will be people who will be offering you services to take care of your room and housekeeping and everything is taken care of. Youth hostels are places which is like a typical hostel wherein there will be deadlines and you might not be able to do too many things over there. A basic cafeteria service and your basic room with a bed will be there, might be with an attached bathroom or might not be, it could be a common bathroom as well. So youth hostels are again places where you can check into in case you don't want to go into a hotel. And you might have camping grounds, which are an excellent way to be in the nature and be with your surroundings in peace as well. A lot of places offer these camping grounds as a place to stay if you're going for trekking and mountaineering and river rafting and all of these adventurous activities, and camping grounds are places where you can stay. Well, friends, that brings us to the end of this, again, a very nice and informative module on types of hotels. I do hope you have enjoyed listening to us, and thank you for watching us.